yesterday we were discussing about multiple images, okay, where we use two mirrors inclined at parallelly in opposite direction so that we get multiple images. So that technique is used nowadays in big mall shops and all. We are using multiple images to get the multiple images in showrooms and all. Okay, coming to one more instrument, wonderful instrument called kaleidoscope. Okay. So kaleidoscope is an instrument where the technique of three rectangular mirrors are used there, like this, in triangle shape. They are fixed there, and above that there is one more triangle shaped mirror fixed there. They cover it and they put some marbles, then Bengal pieces they put, and when they put and observe, they see different patterns. But why I am telling this? Because the same technique we are using in the interior designs, wallpaper designing, artists use this only. Okay, building designs all designed by the technique from the kaleidoscope. Okay, coming to one more, next part is white light. But when you say white light, what is actually white light? See, the simple, the light which we see, actually it is not any color. But if you take a scale, and hold towards the sunlight, you see nearly, you are able to see seven colors only. Seven colors are visible, but they all are mixed with each other. Combined, you can see a rainbow like structure. So that contains seven colors. So white light is actually, white light, it is containing seven colors of acronym called VIBGYOR. It's called VIBGYOR. Okay. So VIBGYOR is there. From this we are able to get the particular colors. Rainbow colors are due to scattering. Generally we say how white light is formed. Why it is called white light? Because see, the best example, rainbow. When rainbow is there, you can see seven colors because of the scattering of light. Light will disperse because of the structure there. Due to that, you can see the different colors. Okay. And you know what is VIBGYOR? You have studied about this in last year. VIBGYOR is violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, red. So these all colors are mixed and forms a white color. But how we are able to see? What are the images? How is it possible to see? Mainly we need eyes. Without eyes or vision, we cannot see anything. Even the eyes is there, if you don't have vision, we cannot see. Then we will try to study how the eye structure is there. What makes us to see the things and what doesn't make us to see the things, what difficulties we face while seeing things. These all things you are learning from the structure of eye. So generally if I say draw the eye diagram, generally we draw like this, in this way. We draw like this, okay. Here one like this is there. Okay. We draw like this. Okay. The same view. See, this part we call cornea. Okay. This part we call iris. There is one more round one inside. That round color is called, that is actually lens. When you say lens, I told, these are convex and concave mirrors. In our eyes also there is one lens called, you know last year about this, you studied about concave mirror, lens and images and all. Okay. Then we try to find actually how the eye structure is made, how our internally eye is developed, what are the things which are helpful for us to see the things. Okay, see, first of all, there is one outer layer, spherical outer layer. Okay, and again inside there are some nerves, like there are some nerves and there is one lens like this, again there are some nerves like this. Okay, and again there is a small part like this. I'll tell what is this part. This is one part. Okay, so again it is taken round like this. Okay, there are some important parts here. What are these important parts? First part I told, this cornea, this white part is called cornea. I'll tell what is the function. Then these are actually called ciliary muscles. Okay. And this part is called iris. Okay. This is actually lens. Again, there is a part which we call this as retina. This anyway, these are all completely, there is a retina. Okay. So this is retina. These nerves which are going to the brain. So these are called optic nerves. This is structure of eyes. Ciliary muscles are there, cornea is there, iris is lens is there. So these are the 4, 5 to 6 important parts of the eyes are there, which plays very important role. Each and every part of the eye is very important for us, because if one is not available, it cannot work. Okay. So cornea is a white part. You can see the white part in your eye. That white part is cornea, which will allow light to enter inside. Light will enter through the cornea, and afterwards the light passes through the lens. Okay. But what is this function of iris? Iris is the one which gives color to your eyes. Sometimes some students, you may have green color of the eyes. That round one, green color. Or brown color. Or black color. Some of them are in blue color. So that iris will give color to the eyes. Due to that, you have different color there. Okay. And inside iris there is a small structure called pupil. What? Pupil. So this pupil will adjust to the light entering to the eye. How? Suppose you suddenly put a torch. This pupil will expand, or sometimes it will relax in size. It will suddenly close. Suddenly will open. So if I blow with a torch on your eyes, suddenly you will close your eyes, because the pupil, what it does, it makes to close the eyes. Okay. So that you will not be affected by the light, strong light. Okay. Then what are ciliary muscles? So these ciliary muscles are holding the lens. They will hold the lens. Okay. So this actually is a lens where the blood will not reach. It will not work on any blood of the body. Only it is a lens like camera. Your eyes and camera are same. Both of them are having the same work of, same working principle. Little changes here. What change? Here in the eyes we can store images in our brain. But in camera we can store in our memory. That is the difference. Nothing is there. Okay. But what is the use of retina here? See, when you see an object, the image of that passes through the lens. Okay. And in this, all this lesson, retina, actually what happens, you know, all the things whichever you see, it will be upright down. Okay. Suppose you see a doll like this. Okay. It is like this. But on the retina, its image will be like this. Retina will take its image as inverted. It will take it as like this. Okay. It will take like this, retina. But again, when it goes to brain, that will correct. The image formed will be corrected by these optical nerves. Oh, optical nerves convert the image and that your brain will take it as state one. Okay. In this way, images are formed and they are old, they are stored here. But how much time it will be staying here? Suppose I'll see one thing. If you see suppose you are watching my class. How much time you are able to keep my image in your mind or brain? How much time it will persist? See, usually so image of anything in your eyes will persist for only 1/16 second. After 1/16 second, image will not be there. it will not be there. Image will not be there. Images are not there after 1 by 16 second. So if we take images, suppose if still images are coming, one by another, it will be there as moving picture for 1 by 16 second. You feel as if you are seeing the movie, what, like that only. But even movies, if you are seeing, watching movies, there for 1 second, 24 pictures will come. Means 24 pictures per second will be moving. But you think 24 per second will be that much speed that the images are made to move. But you are able to see only one particular picture like this. Okay. Then actually, there are on this retina, there are nerve cells, optical nerves or nerve cells. Okay. So this retina contains what? Still something is here. They contain cones and rod. There are nerve cells contain two types of cells, cone cells or rod cells. But what are these all cone cells, rod cells? What they do? Cones are active in the night. They respond when there is light. They work when there is light. Rods are active in the night. So, cones will work during the dim light. Rods will work during the bright light. So, cones will work on bright light. Rods will work on dim light. So, whenever there is light, we are able to see the things. Okay. Suppose you go in the film theater, movie theater. And just suddenly if you enter there, you can't see anything. Why? Because the size of the cones reduced and rods slowly, when you stand for 1 or 2 seconds, 10 to 15 seconds, slowly your rods start working. Means their rods become enlarged in size. Gradually you are able to see the things clearly. So that's why it will work during the dark time. Okay. So again, there is this part, because everywhere the image can be found everywhere, any part of the